Yes, first question of the test was, prove that tau is equal to xfy minus yfx. This is the expression for torque in Cartesian coordinate form. So in xy plane, we had found this expression for day. We had derived this in the class. So same thing is to be done. Second question. A body weighs 63 newton on the surface of earth. What is gravitational force on it due to the earth at a height equal to half the radius of earth? So I think this is NCERT question 28 newton was the answer. So you had to use g dash upon g is equal to r square over r plus h square. Question number 4 is also NCERT question. How much would a body weigh halfway down to the center of earth if it weighed 250 newton on the surface of earth? 125 newton. You have to use g dash is equal to 1 minus d over r into g. Multiply both sides with m. So the same equation we get for weight. Fifth is the effective weight of a body at the center of earth is more than actual weight, less than actual weight, infinite or zero. Zero. Because g becomes zero at the center of earth and so is weight. Height of a geostationary satellite is 36,000 kilometer. Seventh, orbital velocity of a satellite orbiting close to the surface of earth is 7.92. That is approximately 8 kilometer per second. Average density of earth is, yes, क्या ऑप्शन आई आपकी इनमें से? एवरेज डेंसिटी ऑफ अर्थ किसी ने सॉल्व की थी? 5500, 6500, 7500 और 8500 केजी पर मीटर क्यूब. व्हाट इज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन? एनी गेसेस? किसका किसको लगता है ठीक था क्वेश्चन? यस, रेज हैंड जिसका क्वेश्चन ठीक था. डेंसिटी ऑफ अर्थ, वी नो द मास ऑफ अर्थ 6 × 10⁻²⁴ किलोग्राम. वी नो the radius of earth as well, 6400 kilometer. So mass over volume, volume of earth as a sphere, you will use 4/3 πr³. After solving this, what do you get? Yes, kiska answer aaya tha boliye. Yes, who got the answer and what was the option? After solving, what do you get? No one solved this. बोलो, किसी ने सॉल्व नहीं की? यस,
5500.
आपने सॉल्व किया था? आई टोल्ड यू मैम, यू जस्ट हैड टू सॉल्व इट. मुझे भी यही 5500 केजी पर मीटर क्यूब लग रहा है, बट यू सॉल्व दैट फर्स्ट. ठीक है?
यस मैम.
चलिए, सो दिस वॉज ऑल अबाउट द टेस्ट. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू कम्प्लीट दिस डेरिवेशन दैट वी हैड स्टार्टेड. सो वी रीच्ड टाउ इज इक्वल टू आर एफ साइन फाइव, विच इज द पोलर फॉर्म ऑफ टॉर्क. एंड सिंस ए क्रॉस बी इज ऑलवेज इक्वल टू ए बी साइन थीटा, ऑन द सेम लाइन्स वी कैन राइट, सिंस टॉर्क इज इक्वल टू आर एफ साइन फाइव, वी कैन राइट द टॉर्क इन वेक्टर फॉर्म आर क्रॉस एफ. Torque is R cross F. So note down this vector form of torque. And ये मैंने आपको example भी दिया था when we were doing the cross product of vectors. Then I gave you this example also that torque is equal to R cross F. Okay, so we had dropped a perpendicular here. By extending the line of action of force, we had dropped a perpendicular here. Let's name it OL. Okay, this perpendicular distance of this axis of rotation from line of action of force, this is called lever arm. What is D here? Lever arm. What is lever arm? Perpendicular distance of line of action of force from the axis of rotation. This is our axis of rotation. So the distance that the line of action of force is having from this axis of rotation, that is called lever arm. ठीक है, तो लिख लो डेफिनेशन लीवर आर्म की, इट इज द परपेंडिकुलर डिस्टेंस ऑफ लाइन ऑफ एक्शन ऑफ फोर्स, परपेंडिकुलर डिस्टेंस ऑफ लाइन ऑफ एक्शन ऑफ फोर्स फ्रॉम द एक्सिस ऑफ रोटेशन, फ्रॉम द एक्सिस ऑफ रोटेशन. So in this triangle OPL, let us take sine phi. Sine phi is perpendicular OL over hypotenuse OP. That is OL upon OP. Cross multiply, we will write OL equal to OP sine phi. And how much is OP? OP कितना हमने label किया हुआ है, आ रही. So we get R sine phi and OL is our D. So we have found D using trigonometry from triangle OPL. Have a look at this step. If it is not clear, you can ask. Is this step okay? D is equal to R sine phi. So look at this equation. Tau is equal to RF sine phi. So out of this, R sine phi is D. We are left with F here. So put R sine phi equal to D, we get the formula of torque, that this is product of force and lever arm. So this is how we come to the actual formula of torque, starting from Cartesian coordinate form, polar form, and then arriving at the last end result. So see how elaborated our expression was, XFY minus YFX. Then we compacted it to RF sine phi, and then further we compacted it to tau is equal to force into perpendicular distance, FD. So ultimately, this is the formula that we are getting. So now our derivation is complete. Only one step was left. Yes, any doubt up to here? So that's why the unit of torque is force, Newton, and distance, meter. So unit of torque is Newton meter. So this is moment of force, force multiplied by this distance. This is not actually force. This is moment of force, turning effect of force, rotational effect of force. So in the class, I told you how a door can be rotated. If we apply a force perpendicular to it, farthest from the hinges, because in that situation, our sine theta is also maximum equal to 1. And our R is also maximum. So that's why maximum rotational effect is produced very easily. We can rotate the door very easily while opening it or while closing it. Okay, fine. Next, after this, we have a similar derivation with angular momentum. So after torque, our next quantity is angular momentum. Angular momentum is denoted by capital L, angular momentum L. So same way, we are taking this Cartesian coordinate form, right? So this is our origin, and in the same way, this is position vector R, this is point P. Now in place of force, we are having momentum vector P. In place of, now this is angular momentum is moment of momentum. Torque was moment of force. Angular momentum is moment of momentum, turning effect of momentum. So in place of force vector, we are taking here momentum vector. Exactly same thing, but we are taking momentum vector. So same way, this angle with horizontal is beta, this angle was theta, and under the action it is rotating, and new position is Q. This is our new position vector, R plus delta R. and resolve this momentum into two components. If this is beta, this is also corresponding angle beta. So our horizontal component is P cos beta, Px, and vertical component Py is P sine beta. ठीक है, वर्टिकल कंपोनेंट इज पी वाई साइन बीटा. पी वाई ओके, सो सेम टाइप ऑफ डायग्राम ऑलमोस्ट वी आर हैविंग. सो लाइक वी हैड टॉर्क इज इक्वल टू एक्स एफ वाई माइनस वाई एफ एक्स इन द प्लेन. In place of torque, we are having always force, this angular momentum L, and in place of force, we are having momentum. So on the same lines, we can write angular momentum in Cartesian coordinate form, xpy minus ypx. Its proof will be exactly similar, so we are not repeating that. We'll be starting from here and putting in the values of x, y, px and py. You remember p was, x was r cos theta in the derivation and y was r sine theta in the derivation. This is px already we are having, py we are already having. So let us put all these here. L is r cos theta. L is r cos theta, py is p sin beta, y is r sin theta, px is p cos beta. Then taking out rp common, I can write sin beta cos theta minus cos beta sin theta. Similar steps like we did in the derivation of torque, same way we are doing it. Now sin A cos B minus cos A sin B, that is sin A minus B. Sin A minus B. And what is this beta minus theta again? You know that is phi. So we have L is equal to RP sine phi. So this is our angular momentum in polar form. Same way we had torque in polar form, tau is equal to RF sine phi. We have L is equal to RP sine phi. So in vector form, we can also write angular momentum in the same way. L is R cross P. Same way we can write angular momentum as well. L is equal to R cross P. Fine. This is L. Now, again, we extend the line of action of momentum. Drop a perpendicular here. Call it lever arm. Again, perpendicular distance of line of action of momentum from the axis of rotation now. So call this point again L. And in this right angle triangle, OPL, again find sine of phi. That would be OP, OL over OP again. So we get OL from here. OP sine phi. OL is your lever arm. OL is your lever arm. Again, OP is R sine phi. So same way, R sine phi is D. And we get the compacted ultimate formula of angular momentum. It is simply the product of linear momentum at perpendicular distance. It is simply in the same way product of linear momentum and lever arm. So it is the moment of momentum. Moment means any force multiplied by distance. So moment of momentum means momentum multiplied by distance, and yes, we are getting that. So angular momentum is momentum multiplied by lever arm. Okay, so have a look at both the derivations. बिल्कुल सेम वैसे ही करनी है. ये टॉर्क की है और ये एंगुलर मोमेंटम की. द रोल दैट फोर्स इज प्लेइंग इन टॉर्क सेम रोल इज बीइंग प्लेड बाय लीनियर मोमेंटम इन एंगुलर मोमेंटम. एनी डाउट? यहां तक कोई डाउट? यस स्टूडेंट्स, एनी डाउट इफ यू आर हैविंग अप टिल हियर इन एनी स्टेप यू कैन आस्क. Okay, so after this, we find relation between torque and angular momentum. Let's find relation now. How they are related to each other? Relation between torque and angular momentum. So we have L is equal to R cross P. We just derived. Differentiate both sides with respect to time. Differentiate both sides with respect to time. We will get dl by dt, and on the right hand side both are variables. So which rule? Product rule we'll be using. First function into derivative of second plus second function into derivative of first. But side by side, our rule for cross product should also be retained. Wo order bhi disturb nahi hona chahiye side by side. Theek hai? So first function into derivative of second plus second function into derivative of first. But order आपका R cross P वाला रहना चाहिए. तो एक बार मैंने derivative P के साथ attach कर दिया, एक बार मैंने R के साथ. So first function into derivative of second plus second function into derivative of first, but order should be R cross P, R cross P. Fine. चलिए अब what is dp by dt according to Newton's second law? F is equal to dp by dt according to Newton's second law. And what is dr by dt? Velocity is rate of change of displacement. So put in both the values here. dl by dt is equal to r cross f plus v cross p. P is mv. P cross v cross mv. Is this step clear? See, if this step is not clear, you can ask. Yes, clear hai ye step, I hope. चलिए, सो व्हाट इज आर क्रॉस एफ? अभी हमने डिराइव किया टाउ इज इक्वल टू आर क्रॉस एफ डीएल बाय डीटी प्लस एम कॉमन निकाल लेते हैं वी क्रॉस वी. एनी वेक्टर क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाइड बाय इटसेल्फ गिव्स जीरो. ए क्रॉस ए बिकॉज एंगल इज जीरो बिटवीन देम. सो एनी वेक्टर क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाइड विद इटसेल्फ क्रॉस प्रोडक्ट विल बी जीरो. सो वी क्रॉस वी विल गिव अस जीरो. We are left with torque is equal to rate of change of angular momentum. So this is the desired relationship between torque and angular momentum, that torque is equal to rate of change of angular momentum. So remember this relationship always. Okay, clear? Is that clear, students? कोई डाउट यहां तक देख लीजिए, कोई डाउट है तो पूछ सकते हो. यस, एनी स्टेप इफ इट इज नॉट क्लियर यू कैन आंसर. हाँ जी बच्चे, नो डाउट्स एट ऑल. चलिए, तो टॉर्क की डेरिवेशन होगी हमारी, और हमारी एंगुलर मोमेंटम, रिलेशन बिटवीन देम, एवरीथिंग इज डन. फाइन. नेक्स्ट है, इसके बाद लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ एंगुलर मोमेंटम. यू रिमेंबर लाइक वी डिड द लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मोमेंटम, वी हैव द लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ एंगुलर मोमेंटम एज वेल. Law of conservation of angular momentum. So simply, law of conservation of angular. Now, what is the relation? L is equal to I omega. Do you remember? हमने derive किया था. L is equal to I omega in analogy with P is equal to mv. When we compared in a table linear and rotational motions, then I told you in place of angular momentum, in place of linear momentum, we have angular momentum. Moment of inertia in place of mass, and in place of velocity, we have angular velocity. So L is equal to I omega. We have L is equal to I omega. If further the relation is dl by dt, abhi humne derive kiya, tau is equal to dl by dt. Tau is equal to dl by dt. Now, if external torque acting on a system is zero, system is isolated one, no unwanted external torque is acting, put it zero here, dl by dt will be zero. That means L is a constant, angular momentum is a constant. So, what is the condition for conservation of angular momentum? The torque acting on the system must be zero. Angular momentum must be a constant then. Now L is equal to I omega, that means product I omega should be constant. That means I1 omega 1 is equal to I2 omega 2. I1 omega 1, that means is equal to I2 omega 2. Or you can also say that I is inversely proportional to omega. We have so many conceptual questions based on this concept. That angular speed, angular velocity, and moment of inertia is inversely proportional to each other. Right? Moment of inertia ka formula bataya tha na maine aapko, mr square. So that depends upon distance of any particle from the axis of rotation. So more is the distance from the axis of rotation, moment of inertia will be greater, or accordingly smaller also if the distance is lesser. So angular speed and moment of inertia are inversely proportional to each other. We just mean to say that. Okay, angular velocity and moment of inertia are inversely proportional to each other. So we will start doing conceptuals based on this law. So first have a look at this. So the only condition is that the torque acting should be zero. Okay, unwanted torque nahi honi chahiye koi bhi. मतलब रोटेशनल इफेक्ट नहीं होना चाहिए बॉडी का, एक्सटर्नल कोई भी एजेंट उस पर एक्ट नहीं करना चाहिए. सो लेट अस कम अप विद द एग्जांपल्स. Let's come to the first example. A diver performs somersaults in the air before landing into water. आपने देखा होगा कि जब एक स्विमर जो है वो डाइविंग करने से पहले जंप करता है इनटू द वाटर, ही कर्ल्स हिज बॉडी सो मेनी टाइम्स. दीज कर्लिंग्स आर कॉल्ड somersaults. So why does a diver perform somersaults in the air? This is the question. A diver performs somersaults in the air by curling his body. A moment of inertia kam ho jayega because it depends upon distance from the axis of rotation. To ye agar axis of rotation hai aur usne apni body ko curl kar liya hai, kahan wo expand ho raha hai, kahan usne body ko curl kar liya hai, to distance kam ho gaya from the axis of rotation, r will be less, so moment of inertia will be less. According to the law of conservation of momentum, angular speed of rotation will be more. So he will acquire greater angular speed before landing into water. So uski angular speed of rotation काफी ज्यादा हो जाएगी, ठीक है? उससे क्या होगा? That will help him in covering a long distance inside water. तो वो यहाँ पे jump करेगा, निकलेगा दूसरे end से. तो इतनी सारी angular momentum कैसे उसने gain की? एंगुलर मोमेंटम तो कांस्टेंट है, यहाँ पे एंगुलर वेलोसिटी कैसे गेन की यहाँ पे उसने? बाय कर्लिंग हिज बॉडी. सो बाय कर्लिंग हिज बॉडी ही इज एबल टू कवर अ लॉट अ लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस इनसाइड वाटर आफ्टर डाइविंग इनटू इट. और आपने नोटिस किया अगर होगा कि जब वो लैंड करता है तो फिर से अपनी बॉडी को ऐसे स्ट्रेट कर लेता है, कर्ल नहीं करता, ठीक है? तो वो स्ट्रेट करने से क्या होगा? व्हाट विल हैपन? He will again increase the moment of inertia just before landing into water, or angular speed of rotation. अब उसकी कम हो जाएगी, तो he will gently slide into water. तो एक moment पहले वो gently slide कर जाएगा water के अंदर. But moment before that he was curling his body right from diving, ठीक है, till the moment he reaches water surface. तो वो उससे क्या कर रहा है? वो angular velocity gain कर लेगा. So this is your first example of law of conservation of angular momentum. I hope you got it. Is that clear? So देख लीजिए, कोई doubt है यहाँ तक तो पूछ सकते हो. Rest of the examples we'll continue on Thursday. हाँ जी, पूछ लो, कोई doubt है तो आपका.